News at Night for Monday, March the 29th. I'm Collette Linden.
I'm Craig Huckerby. We have a couple little weak disturbances to deal with this week, but man, oh man, is the Easter weekend looking nice. I'll give you those details coming up.
On March the 26th, officers with Sault Ste. Marie Police Patrol Services charged 28-year-old Corey McIntyre with robbery. At around 1 o'clock in the afternoon, a woman was walking westbound on Queen Street East, and it's alleged that the accused approached her, knocked her to the ground, and demanded money. The victim did not give the accused any money, and he left the area. The incident was caught on a surveillance camera by a local area business, documenting the violent encounter. The accused can be seen at the top of the video frame, suddenly taking a run at the victim and using his arm to deliver a clothesline blow, sending her backwards to the ground. EMS responded, and the victim was transported to hospital to receive treatment for her injuries. Officers located the accused at 4:08 p.m. and arrested. He is charged with robbery and was held for wash court. Sometime shortly after 1 o'clock this morning, Sault Police Services, including members of the Emergency Response Unit, patrol units, and the ballistics vehicle, attended a home on the West End. Officers could be seen in the 200 block of Beverly Street. They had shut the road down for a short period of time. Sault Online has reached out to the police for any further information and will bring it to you if it becomes available. On March the 28th, officers with patrol services charged 37-year-old William McDonald and 22-year-old Brent Wimet with break and enter. At 6:37 in the morning, officers responded to a break and enter in progress at a business in the 200 block of Second Line West. When officers arrived, the two accused had fled the area. The K-9 unit attended and located the two accused around 1:30 in the afternoon. They were both arrested and charged with break and enter, theft under $5,000, and breach of probation. They are both scheduled to appear in court on May the 3rd. Ontario is reporting 2,094 new cases of COVID-19 and 10 additional deaths today. According to data released by the province, 841 COVID-19 patients were in the hospital, with 382 of those listed as being in intensive care units. Here locally, Algoma Public Health is reporting 2 new cases of COVID-19 from Sault Ste. Marie and area. APH is advising anyone who visited the Tim Hortons located at the corner of Great Northern Road and Third Line, specifically 628 Third Line East, to either through the walk-in or drive-through on March 23rd and 24th from 5 a.m. to 1:30 p.m. that there is a low-risk potential exposure to COVID-19. In addition, APH is also advising that anyone who visited Bath & Body Works in the Station Mall on March the 27th from 11 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. is also considered to be at low risk exposure level. Ontario is expanding COVID-19 vaccine bookings today for people 70 years of age and older to additional regions, including several GTA municipalities. In a news release Sunday evening, the government said that people will be able to book appointments for the vaccine online or through the call center starting at 8 a.m. Previously, the minimum age in most regions was 75. Those eligible can book online or by calling 1-888-999-6488. A joint World Health Organization, China, studied on the origins of COVID-19, says that transmission of the virus from bats to humans through another animal is the most likely scenario and that a lab leak is extremely unlikely. According to a draft copy obtained by the Associated Press, the findings offer little to new insight into how the virus first emerged and leave many questions unanswered, though that was expected. But the report does provide more detail on the reasoning behind the researchers' conclusions. The team proposed further research in every area except the lab leak hypothesis. The report, which is expected to be made public on Tuesday, is being closely watched since discovering the origins of the virus could help scientists prevent future pandemics, but it's also extremely sensitive since China bristles at any suggestion that it is to blame for the current one. Repeated delays in the report's release have raised questions about whether the Chinese side was trying to skew its conclusions. China has rejected this criticism today. Sometime shortly after 1 o'clock this morning, Sault Police Services, including members of the Emergency Response Unit, patrol units, and the ballistics vehicle, attended a home on the West End. Officers could be seen in the 200 block of Beverly Street. They had shut the road down for a short period of time. Sault Online has reached out to the police for any further information and will bring it to you if it becomes available. Sault Police Services sent an update this morning regarding Jeremy Rawlinson. Jeremy has been located safely and is no longer considered missing. Originally reported missing on the 26th of March, Jeremy was reported to be last seen in the area of Trunk Road and Queensgate Boulevard.
About saying that once we lose our snow, even if we lose it early, chances are we're going to get it back just like we did this past weekend. But do we have any more snow in the forecast? And how is your long Easter weekend looking? I'll give you what we know coming up.
Don't click it, Mike. It's a scam.
Oh, hi, Voice of Reason. It looks legit.
Don't click. Listen to your Voice of Reason before you act.
I deleted it.
Canada.ca/bscamsmart can help.
Is going to a party really worth it? Putting yourself at risk puts everyone at risk. Help limit the spread of COVID-19.
And welcome back, everyone. Well, tonight we're going to start losing some clouds, as we've been stuck with the clouds all day long, but our temperatures are going to drop to about freezing, and then we're going to start seeing our temperatures build up during the overnight. The big thing tonight is the winds. The winds from the south will be quite gusty at 50 to 60 kilometers an hour, and that may just help get rid of the snow that we picked up on the weekend. And if that doesn't do it, well, the rain maybe will tomorrow. This is the overnight temperatures around Northern Ontario. And you can see we're all pretty much close to the freezing mark, minus one in Thunder Bay, minus one in Wawa, seeing some snow up there, and seeing some snow in Timmins at minus three. So this is the systems satellite map for tonight. You can see, don't worry about this stuff. It's not even reaching the ground. It is flurry activity. We don't have to worry about that. Then we're going to see some clearing, and then we're going to see these clouds fill in by morning and eventually give us some showers right there, but not a lot of showers. We're not anticipating a heavy rain amount. It could be drizzle to light showers starting mainly in the afternoon. Temperatures though should be quite comfortable for this time of year. We'll take a look at the systems map for our day tomorrow. You can see here's that one front coming in that's going to produce the showers, along with that warm front, which is pushing the warm air in for our overnight tonight, giving us our daytime high tomorrow as soon as you wake up at plus five. And then we see some showers, but then we see a little bit of clearing, and then we might see another secondary front that, if there's any moisture left in the atmosphere, that may fall as flurry activity, but not accumulating like it did this past weekend. And then we have Easter coming with a lot of nice weather. This is the next 3 days though. So we'll start with some cloud in the morning. Temperatures though, bumping right up from 5 degrees when you wake up to 11 degrees in the afternoon as we enjoy that southerly wind. And just light showers are in the forecast. Then on Wednesday, we do have flurry activity. We're not showing it there on the board, but that could come in early Wednesday morning. Temperatures though are taking a dive with that secondary front at plus two and overnight low of minus 10. And then for Thursday, nice and sunny, temperatures still on the cool side at plus three. We could bump that up to plus five. And then we start seeing a really nice weekend shaping up with Friday, lots of sun. That's Good Friday. It's a day off for most people, 11 degrees, 15 degrees on Saturday with a mix of sun and cloud, 15 degrees for Sunday on Easter Sunday, still looking pretty nice. And even on Easter Monday, 13 degrees and a mix of sun and cloud. So the end of this week's looking really, really nice. We just have to get rid of this unstable air that we have currently. That is your weather for right now. Jacob Moore is standing by with all your sports right after this.
Is going to a party really worth it? Putting yourself at risk puts everyone at risk. Help limit the spread of COVID-19.
One of our three Sault Ste. Marie locations. You do life, we do taxes.
I'm Jacob with All Your Sports. We had a really, really busy day, so let's jump right in.
Six power play goals this year, turned it over. Three on three, the Stars can race. It's Como behind.
Oh, there's an injury.
Oh, there's
behind.
A bad injury, and it's Aaron Ekblad. Oh, he is in a tremendous amount of pain.
Florida Panthers defenseman Aaron Ekblad was taken off the ice on a stretcher with a leg injury midway through the second period on Sunday versus the Dallas Stars. An air cast was applied to Ekblad's left leg. Ekblad has 11 goals this season, tied for the most among NHL defensemen. It is unknown how long Ekblad will be out with this injury. Stay tuned to On TV for the update on Aaron Ekblad. The NHL announced on Sunday updates to the 2020-2021 regular season schedule. These updates involve 11 games involving the North Division. These teams are the Leafs, the Jets, the Flames, the Oilers, the Canadiens, and the Senators. The CFL met up with the CFL Players Association to try to work out a deal to start the season on time. TSN reports that this deal includes a 20% cut to the player's salary. The average salary of a CFL player ranges from $80,000 to $100,000 and anywhere in the preseason to $500 a week to $700 a week. CFL players have mixed reactions and they are mostly negative. Stay locked on TV to find out if the CFL season starts on time or if we even have a season at all. Toronto Raptors point guard Kyle Lowry is questionable for their next game against the Pistons. Lowry missed the Raptors' last game against the Trailblazers due to soreness in his foot. Kyle Lowry has had a pretty good season so far this year with 17.2 points per game, 5.6 rebounds, and 7.4 assists this season. The Raptors are currently sitting 11th in the Eastern Conference.
Scores! Charlie Coyle for the third time in two games.
The Buffalo Sabres are looking to snap a 17-game losing streak. The Sabres are facing off against the Philadelphia Flyers, who have also been struggling of late, only winning 3 of their last 10 games. If the Sabres manage to lose another one, they will tie a record since the 2000 era with an 18-game losing streak. The only other team that's done this was the Pittsburgh Penguins during Crosby's rookie season.
Save on Larson, rebound, a lunging stop, and a great one, point blank on Dominic Cahoon.
Michael Hutchinson will be back in between the pipes tonight versus the Oilers. Jack Campbell did get the nod the other night and continued his winning streak. However, he said he wasn't feeling 100% during the game and after. Jack Campbell did miss the practice on Sunday, and we believe this is to do with his leg injury he's been battling with the entire season. This will be Michael Hutchinson's 7th game, and he has posted a .922 save percentage and a .222 goals against average this season. We have two games going on in the NHL's Northern Division, so let's jump right in. The first game we have is the Toronto Maple Leafs versus the Edmonton Oilers. The Leafs and the Oilers are sitting first and second in the Northern Division. This means this game is very important to both of these teams. The Leafs are only 3 points ahead of the Oilers and want to push that gap up to 5, while Edmonton wants to close the gap to just 1 point. The next game we have is the Jets versus the Flames. The Calgary Flames really need this win as they have been pretty up and down of late. Head coach Daryl Sutter says if they don't start winning soon, their chances are going to become harder and harder to make the playoffs. The Winnipeg Jets are looking to also close that gap from third, second to first. It's getting very jumbled up there in the top three for the North. Well, that's it for sports, but hang around, don't go anywhere. Colette's got more news coming up.
Is going to a party really worth it? Putting yourself at risk puts everyone at risk. Help limit the spread of COVID-19.
The COVID-19 pandemic in Canada is serious. We must continue to practice all public health measures. Follow local guidelines for gatherings. Maintain physical distancing. Wash your hands, wear a mask, and download the COVID Alert app. If you have symptoms, even mild ones, stay home. Protect yourself and others. We've come too far to stop now.
A message from the Government of Canada.
For close to 1 hour on March the 27th, members of the community looking for council to save Pointe-Aux-Chênes had a protest. Approximately 70 people of all ages turned up on the corner of Pym and McNabb to show support for keeping the campground open. Chants from the protesters were met with honks of vehicles in support of their cause. Ward 5 councillor, who originally voted to keep the park open, did show up to speak with the protesters. There were a couple of citizens mingling with the crowd who are concerned that this is a done deal, as well as developers ready in the wings to swoop in for the property. Stay with Sue Online as we continue to follow this constantly developing story. Even though the city has closed down their outdoor skating rinks weeks ago, you can still enjoy the popular winter sport if you know where to go. The Machine Shop built an outdoor rink back in the fall on the west side of their parking lot. Owner Tony Porco said that it has been in operation for most of the winter. Even though a recent warm spell where temperatures reached 16 degrees outside, skaters were still able to enjoy the ice surface and the warm spring weather. If you are looking to extend this fun pastime, simply head on over to their website to find out when you can book some time for ice skating, a hockey event, or birthday party at the rink. Seniors 70 years of age and older in the York region will be heading to Canada's Wonderland this week, not for the rides, but to get a COVID-19 shot. The theme park's drive-through vaccination clinic opened today and will welcome vehicles by appointment only. Booking a vehicle will allow up to 4 eligible residents to roll up their sleeves. York Region says the appointments are fully booked through to Wednesday, but people are being encouraged to check back for additional appointments as more vaccines become available. Police are expected to release more details today in their investigation of a stabbing rampage that left a young woman dead and injured 6 others in around a library in North Vancouver on Saturday. A 28-year-old man was charged Sunday with second-degree murder. The Integrated Homicide Investigation Team said that Yannick Banadeau is in police custody after undergoing surgery for self-inflicted wounds. Police have not named the woman who died but said that she was in her 20s. A bird strike causing an engine compressor failure has been formally declared as the cause of last year's fatal crash of a Canadian military snowbird demonstration jet in Kamloops, BC. The Royal Canadian Air Force's Directorate of Flight Safety released its final report on Monday, which took place on May the 17th and killed Captain Jen Casey. The public affairs officer for the aerobatics team said the investigation found that a single small bird was sucked into the engine of the aircraft Snowbird 11 following takeoff. That resulted in a compressor stall and loss of thrust as the aircraft was trying to climb. Tasha Beads will lead a water walk for Junction Creek in Sudbury, taking place from May the 5th to the 9th this year. The ceremonial movement of the water walk is in honor of the water's gift of life for all of creation. They have begun to prepare for the ceremonial walk by cleaning up the path they will walk along. Tasha has walked over 7,000 kilometers to protect and raise awareness for the water's well-being. We will be following the walk as Tasha carries water in ceremony for Junction Creek. Okay, so I think by the sounds of your weekend forecast, I can do an outside Easter egg hunt.
Oh, definitely, for sure. Temperatures are going to be in the mid-teens. We're going to see some sun, a little bit of cloud, no snow, no rain. It's going to be perfect.
That is just perfect, and a perfect way to end the newscast. For Craig Huckerby and Jacob Moore, I'm Colette Linden. Stay tuned for more news and weather coming right up.